Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Dr. Monu and in this video we are going to talk about MRCS examination. I have already made a video about pleb examination and recently I made one about MRCP, and since then I had been getting a lot of requests to make a video about MRCS, so this is for those guys. Now before we talk solely about MRCS examination, I would like to give you a very short preview here. There are two ways that you can enter UK healthcare system. The one which is the regular way is you do your MBBS, then you write pleb 1 and pleb 2 examination. Now I have a full video about pleb exam that I uploaded about an year ago and the video has over 90,000 views. So do not forget to check that video if you wish to know about pleb in detail. Once you have cleared your pleb examination, you will get a license to work in UK. After clearing pleb, you will work for 2 years under foundation training. In short, we refer it to as FY1 or FY2. After finishing foundation training, you will do 2 years core medical training or CMT. After finishing this, you will enter specialty training, which will be for 4 to 6 years. Now, this is the regular pleb pathway. The another pathway that you can opt here is MRCS or MRCP1. You finish your MBBS, you are done with your internship and you have a few years clinical experience and you have a good clinical exposure. What you can do is to write MRCS if you wish to work in surgery branch, or MRCP if you wish to work in medicine branch. Once you have cleared your MRCS or MRCP examination, you will directly enter level ST3. Now if you don't understand the terms FI1, CMT or what is ST3 and all of that, please go and watch the video which is about pleb. I have explained thoroughly about all this process, so it will be easier for you to understand. After clearing the exam, you'll enter at ST3 level. We'll talk about this in a minute in this video. Now let's focus solely on the MRCS examination. It stands for Membership Examination of the Surgical Royal Colleges of Great Britain and Ireland, or Specialty Training in Surgery, or even in the simpler terms, PG Diploma for Surgeons, whichever definition explains you. There are 4 colleges that you can get a membership from after writing this examination, after passing the examination. The Royal Colleges of Surgeons of Edinburgh, Glasgow, Ireland and England. The most famous one and the most oldest one is the Edinburgh. You can opt for any of these according to your preference. The exam itself is of 2 parts. The first one is written examination, which is held in 1 day, same day. It consists of 2 sessions, morning session and afternoon session. Morning session is applied basic science paper, which is of 3 hours, and principle of surgery paper, which occurs in the afternoon session, is of 2 hours. Now the total number of MCQs are 300. You have to choose single best answer. The exam fees is about £550. This is if you wish to give the examination in UK, the fees is 550, that is the minimal fee. But if you wish to give the examination from any other part of the world, they have the centers there. You need to pay an extra about 8200 pounds, I guess. So more than 550 if you wish to give the examination from any other center from the world. The passing rate for part A is about 30%. The second exam, part A is more about theoretical and part B is more of viva question. The type of exam is OSCE, that is Objective Structured Clinical Examination. For this, the exam fees is about £997 and passing rate is about 50%. So part B has more passing rate as compared to part A. The part B exam consists of 20 stations. Each station is of 10 minutes. So the exam overall is about 4 hours long. You can give these examinations, part A and part B, from anywhere around the world. In 20 stations, 2 stations are for your preparation, you can prepare during the time, and 80 stations for examining. You'll get about 1 minute. The examiner will briefly give you the case and explain you about the case. You'll get like 1 minute reading time and then you'll start explaining the case to him. In this, if you don't understand in simpler terms, you'll be given a patient and you are asked about, you are tested about your clinical skills, communication skills, history taking, and how you are going to diagnose the patient. In the stations, they check you on the 2 bases, applied knowledge and applied skills. In applied knowledge, they are going to test you about anatomy, surgical pathology, applied surgical science. In applied skills, they are going to test you on communication skills and history taking. So the examiner is going to give you marks on the basis of both of them and you have to pass both applied knowledge and applied skills. Number of attempts for part A is 6 and number of attempts for part B in total are 4. Now a short FAQ sort of thing here. MRCS is required prior to application to higher surgical training, that is ST3 in UK that I told you. If you have cleared MRCP or MRCS, you can directly enter the level ST3. There is no MRCS for orthopedics, or if you are an Indian graduate, you can consider MRCS to be equivalent to MS in general surgery or ENT. Now a lot of people get confused between MRCS and FRCS. MRCS is beginning of your PG or specialization, whereas FRCS is the end of your PG. I'll make a video about FRCS also. MRCS is membership and FRCS is fellowship of the same colleges. Exam can be taken across many countries around the world that I talked about. And you have to clear exam A before exam B. This is in the order. You cannot give exam B before appearing for the exam A. The eligibility is very simple. You must hold a primary medical qualification that is recognized by GMC. GMC stands for General Medical Council of England. Benefits of MRCS is, if you wish to work in Middle East, I have made a video about Middle East as well. Okay guys, if you wish to know about any of the countries, like I have already made videos about USMLE, PLAB, MRCP, about Canadian examination, Australian medical examination, how to get a job in Ireland, Dubai, all those videos I have already covered. So if you are interested in any of those, please go and check out on the channel. If you wish to work in the Middle East, you'll get almost paid twice if you have the MRCS degree. MRCS is also recognized in India. A lot of people were asking about this. The time required for the preparation is about 6 months for one part of the exam, though it entirely depends upon you. The salary here, I've given gross basic pay. These level I have talked about in the PLAB video, so if you're still confused, go and check that video out. FY1, which is like the internship part, you get paid about £27,000. FY2, £31,500. CT or ST1 and 2, £37,000. And ST3, that is when you enter into MRCS or MRCP, about £40,000 per annum. It is not monthly. And if you talk about hourly basis, it is about £35 to £50 if you are up until ST1 or 2 level. And after you have entered ST3, you'll get about 60 to 80 pounds per hour. But the salary depends upon the region also. Like, there are a lot of factors that are into the salary. I have given you an average here, that is the gross basic pay. This is it for this video. If you have any queries, please, you can drop down them in the comment section below. And I'll also upload some important links from where you can prepare for the MRCS examination, like the resources and material links. Also, do not forget to subscribe to my Instagram channel. There's a channel on Instagram and Telegram as well. I daily post about 10 to 20 MCQs on Instagram. And I have recently uploaded a video about FMG and its content, like how to prepare for FMG examination. So do not forget to follow me on Instagram as well. Guys, thank you so much for the love that you have been showing to this channel. We are so close to getting 1 million views in total on the channel. So I'm really, really grateful for that. Do not forget to share and subscribe to